अब आओ हम लोग देखें ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एल्गोरिदम क्या है। एल्गोरिदम इज ए स्टेप वाइज प्रोसीजर टू सॉल्व ए ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम। एनी एल्गोरिदम इज ए स्टेप बाय स्टेप प्रोसीजर टू सॉल्व सम प्रॉब्लम और इवेल्युएट सम आइडिया और एनीथिंग एल्स, बट इट इज ए स्टेप बाय स्टेप मेथड। सी स्टेप वन, फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम एंड राइट द डाटा इन ए मैट्रिक्स फॉर्म। फर्स्ट स्टेप, फॉर्मुलेशन इज सिमिलर टू द एलपी प्रॉब्लम। एलपी प्रॉब्लम मीन्स लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम। द ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन इज द टोटल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कॉस्ट एंड द कंस्ट्रेंट्स आर सप्लाई एंड डिमांड रेस्ट्रिक्शंस। स्टेप टू, इनिशियल बेसिक फिजिबल सॉल्यूशंस, इन शॉर्ट वी राइट इट एज IBFS। वी हैव थ्री मेथड्स फॉर इनिशियल बेसिक फिजिबल सॉल्यूशंस। फर्स्ट, नॉर्थ वेस्ट कॉर्नर मेथड NWC मेथड, इन शॉर्ट वी राइट। सेकेंड, लीस्ट कॉस्ट मेथड LCM और समटाइम्स यू विल फाइंड मैट्रिक्स मिनिमम मेथड। एंड थर्ड इज योर वोगेल्स अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेथड, इट मीन्स VAM और पेनल्टी मेथड। द इनिशियल सोल्यूशन ऑफ स्टेप टू, दिस स्टेप टू मस्ट सेटिस्फाई फर्स्ट ए सोल्यूशन मस्ट बी फिजिबल, दैट इज इट मस्ट सेटिस्फाई सप्लाई एंड डिमांड। देर आर टू रेस्ट्रिक्शन, सप्लाई एंड डिमांड। सो सोल्यूशन मस्ट बी सेटिस्फाइंग सप्लाई एंड डिमांड रेस्ट्रिक्शंस। सेकेंड, बी नंबर ऑफ पॉजिटिव एलोकेशन इज इक्वल टू M+N-1, वेयर M इज योर नंबर ऑफ रोज एंड N इज योर नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स। लेट अस नाउ वन मोर कॉन्सेप्ट, डी जनरेट सोल्यूशन। एनी सोल्यूशन दैट सेटिस्फाई ए एंड बी, ए एंड बी मीन्स दिस टू ए एंड बी, एनी सोल्यूशन दैट सेटिस्फाई ए एंड बी इज कॉल्ड नॉन डिजेनरेट बेसिक फिजिबल सोल्यूशन। If any solution satisfies NB, then it is non-degenerate, and otherwise it will be called generate solution, degenerate solution. Now come to NWC method. NWC means northwest corner method. Northwest corner means you go to into the direction northwest, and from northwest, starting from northwest, we will go up to south. Is southeast direction, so it is a diagonal. We will make a diagonal. See here, the method is as under. Step one, choose the upper left. Upper left means northwest cell, and allocate is equal to the minimum of the rim values of first row and first column. That is minimum of A1 B1 is equal to X1 1. Earlier we have seen a table containing supply demand. Destination origin. So this is all about from that A1 B1. So we will allocate in the northwest cell, means upper left cell, the minimum of A1 B1. We'll denote it by X11. With an example, it will be clear. Next, step two. If B1 is greater than A1, suppose B1 is greater than A1, then we move down vertically. To move down vertically to the second row and take X21. After X11, X21, go X21, cell 21. 21 means second row, first column. It is equal to minimum of A2 and B1 minus X11 in the cell 21. Is it okay? Next, if B1 is less than A1, we move right horizontally to the second column. In case the horizontal portion A1 is greater than vertical portion B1, then move right horizontally and take X12. X12 means in the cell 12, means 12 means first row and second column. It is equal to minimum of A1 minus X11 and B2 in the cell 12. Third, in the step 2, if A1 is equal to B1, suppose sometimes you will get A1 is equal to B1, then allocate X11 is equal to A1 or B1 in the cell 11 and move diagonally to the cell 22 in case A1 is equal to B1. Next, step 3, continue above steps till an allocation is made in the southeast. SE means southeast cell. Start from northwest and go up to southeast. So movement is diagonal movement. If A1 is equal to B1, then the second allocation will be x12 is equal to 0 in the cell 1 2, or x21 is equal to 0 in the cell 2 1. Note, all the rim requirements must be satisfied. Now we have one example. Use NWC method, NWC means northwest corner method, to find an initial basic feasible solution to the given transportation problem. These D1, D2, D3, D4, these are our destinations. These S1, S2, S3, these are our origins, or you can say supply. This is our demand, D1. At D1, we have 5 demand, D2, 8 demand, D3, 7 demand, D4, 14 demand. And this is our supply. S1, 7 supply, S2, 9 supply, S3, 18 supply. And total of this is 34. Total of this horizontal is 34. So rim requirements are satisfied, means the solution is, the given exam problem is feasible. This is our A1, A2, A3, and this is our B1, B2, B3, and B4. Now see its solution. Here, X1 will be minimum of A1, B1, minimum of 7, 5. Remember, where is 7? So this is your 7 in the first row and 5 in the first column. So take minimum of 5 and 7, means it is 5, and allocate in the cell 1 1. Go to the next page. So it is minimum 7 5 is 5 in the cell 1 1. Now first column is exhausted. See, in the first column we have 5 units, so first column is exhausted. So x12 means in the first row and second column, minimum of 7 minus 5 means 2 and B2. So minimum of 2 and 8, this is equal to 2 in cell 1 2. See it here. See, this is your 5, this column is exhausted. So in from 7 you have 2 units, and from here you have 8. So minimum of 2 and 8 is 2. So allocate in this cell 1 2, minimum of 2 and 8. So we will allocate 2 here, 5 here and 2 here. Next, X22 is equal to minimum of 9 and 8 minus 2. 9 and 8 minus 2 means minimum of 9 and 6 is 6 in the cell 2 2. So second column is exhausted. Second column is having 8 units. See, it is exhausted. Next, X23 will be minimum of this 9 minus 6 and 7. So it is 3 in cell 2 3. So second row is exhausted. Next, X33 is equal to minimum of 7 minus 3, 18. It is equal to 4 in 3, 3. So third column is exhausted. Next, X34 is equal to minimum of 18 minus 4, 14. Is equal to 14 in 3, 4. All allocations are made. Here, see also M plus N minus 1 means M is your 3 number of rows, N is your 4 number of columns. So 3 plus 4 minus 1, it is 6. And 6 allocations are made. So 2 conditions A and B are supplied, are satisfied. Also, total supply equals total demand. It means it is 34. Thus, a non-degenerate basic feasible solution exists. Thus, the total transportation cost is 5 into 19. 5 means allocation and 19 means units given earlier, plus cost, plus 2 into 30. 19 is the cost for cell from S1 to D1. Plus 2 into 30. 30 is from S1 to D2. Plus 6 into 30. S2 to D2, plus 3 into 4 to 40, plus 4 into 70, plus 14 into 20, it is equal to rupees 1015. See, from the figure, see here, see carefully the figure here. This is our cell 11. This is 5. This is our 7. Minimum of 5 and 7 is 5. 5 given here. This is exhausted. Leave this. Then this remains 7 minus 5 means it is 2. And it is a 2 minus minimum of 2 and 8 is 2. Allocate here 2. So this 5 plus 2, 7. So this first row is exhausted. Now this is 8. 8 minus 2, 6. So it will have 6. Now you will have leave first row and first column. So we have this one. Matrix. Now this is your 6. This is your 9. Minimum of 6 and 9 is 6. Allocate 6 here. Minimum. So this 8 is exhausted. This 2 plus 6 means 8. Second column is exhausted. Now here 9 minus 6 means 3. It has 3 units. So we have this matrix. Now this is 3. This is 7. Minimum of 3 and 7 is 3. So allocate 3 here. 2, 40. 19, 30, 30 and 40. He allocate here 3. So this row is exhausted. Now here balance is 4 units. So 4 and 18. Minimum of 4 and 18 is 4. Allocate here 4. So this is also exhausted. 1, 2, 3 column exhausted. So we have only this one. So it is 18. And 18 minus 4 is 14. 14 here, 14 here. So allocate here in this 20, 14 units. So allocation is made in the cell 11, 12, 22, 23, and 33, and 34. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There are total 6 allocations. So 5 into 19 plus 30 into 2 plus 30 into 3 plus 40 into 4 plus 70 into 4 plus 40 into 4 plus 70 into 4 plus 20 into 14. So it will give you transportation cost 3 into 40 plus 4 into 70, 5 into 19 plus 2 into 30 plus 6 into 30 plus 3 into 40 plus 4 into 70 is equal to plus 14 into 20 rupees 1015. After this, you will have one problem, but first see this problem also. A company, no, remain, leave this, first note down all of them.